Hey there! Welcome to Life Noggin. For centuries, plagues have been popping up all over the world, causing the deaths of hundreds of millions of people. Symptoms are pretty gruesome, ranging from swollen lymph nodes to death of tissues like skin. We now know that the disease known as plague is a bacteria called Yersinia pestis that's found in rodents and their fleas. And while the number of casualties is far less devastating than it used to be, due to much better sanitation and pest control methods, it still exists today. But there are steps that you could take to stay safe if you're ever near an outbreak. Plagues often occur in tropical climates, like Madagascar, who reported over 2,300 cases in 2017, rather than places like the United States, where just a few cases are diagnosed each year. If you live in a region that's likely to have an outbreak, organizations like the Center for Disease Control and Prevention and the World Health Organization have identified methods to help the public avoid contracting the disease. Transmission can occur in a few ways. Most often, the bacteria enters your body through a flea bite and travels through the lymphatic system where it reproduces itself. This type of transmission results in bubonic plague, named after the swollen and painful lymph nodes called buboes that it creates. If left untreated, bubonic plague can turn into septicemic plague, where tissues can turn black and die. You can also get this type of plague by handling an infected animal. If the bacteria infection spreads to the lungs, it can advance to pneumonic plague. This one is the most severe and can be fatal if not treated quickly. It's also the only form that can transmit from person to person through the air. Luckily, that's pretty rare, since you have to be in close or direct contact with them for that to happen. So I'm not saying you have to lock yourself in a bunker and stay away from civilization. Just stay away from people who might be sick. Flea bites and physical contact, though, are pretty common. So to stay protected, you need to keep your home free from rodents who may be carrying or are infected by fleas by clearing away any piles of brush or rocks that they can use as a home and remove any potential food sources. You can also keep yourself free from fleas by using insect repellent when outdoors and keeping fleas off your pets using flea control products. Again, Triangle Bob, you don't have to stay in a bunker, you just have to spray yourself down and get rid of those fleas. If you're a hunter, make sure you use gloves when handling animals. And everyone should avoid contact with any fluids or tissue of people or pets who are infected. Triangle Bob, get out of the bunker. I'm not sick. No one here is sick. You're gonna be fine. Thanks to modern medicine and antibiotics, if you do get the disease, your prognosis is a lot better than it was a century ago. Nowadays, most people can be cured with a round of antibiotics if it's diagnosed early enough. No, Triangle Bob, that's not me saying you can just make friends with a bunch of rats. You know what? I'm gonna let him do his thing, and I'm gonna do mine. So are there any other diseases that you want us to talk about next? Let me know in the comment section below. Curious to know if a virus can get a virus? Check out this video. In the early 2000s, scientists discovered an exceptional virus that altered our understanding of life itself. At first, experts assumed it was bacteria. As always, my name is Blocko. This has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.